Hi friends, and welcome to Crumbs from Gerard. The reading in Mark today is from Isaiah. And let me give you a little background to this reading. The great superpower in those days was Assyria, and they wanted to attack Judah. Now Judah was terrified and so wanted the help of Egypt, another superpower. Isaiah tells them that the Lord doesn't want you to turn to Egypt, but the king refuses to listen to what the Lord is saying through Isaiah and goes to Egypt for help. Unfortunately, Egypt can't really help them, and so finally Judah is taken into captivity, into exile. This is the background. And here now you hear some of the most beautiful and tender words coming from the Lord in this situation. First of all, the Lord says, I can't really help you when you do something wrong. You have to bear the consequence of it, because I am a just God. And so Egypt and so Judah is forced to go into exile. But then what? Listen to what the Lord says through Isaiah. The Lord longs to be gracious to you. He rises to show you compassion. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all who wait for the Lord. So the Lord longs to show you and be gracious to you. He doesn't just sit down quietly in his graciousness, but he rises up to show compassion to you. All that is required is that we wait for the Lord. And then Isaiah says that if you wait for the Lord, you will weep no more. And the Lord now will show you his grace. In the Old Testament, the blessing of the Lord is not just your spiritual graces, but material graces also, as the reading says. And he will give rain for the seed, and produce of the ground will be rich and plenteous. In that day your cattle will graze in a large pasture, and upon every lofty mountain and every high hill there will be brooks running with water. So this is the blessing that the Lord gives. But the most beautiful blessing of the Lord is the Lord's voice will be heard. Earlier, they refused to listen to the Lord. They shut their ears, they shut their eyes. And so the reading says, your eyes shall see your teacher, and your ears shall hear a word behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it, when you turn to the right or when you turn to the left. Now you will experience the Lord as your true North Star, always pointing the right direction for you. And therefore, now for you, put on your thinking cap. This is the high point of Christianity, to follow the Lord, your true North Star. He whispers quietly in your heart and always points the direction you should go, whether you would like it or not. There are other shooting stars which brighten up the sky for a little while and disappear, but the North Stars always point in the right direction. So do you want to, really want to follow your heart, your North Star?